No four ways again. And what's interesting is, you know, I parked out here by myself. You see, I got like two spots over here and two spots between the next guy. Those are some thick plates, like 2 inch. Anyway, I parked over here by myself. I'm a reefer. A lot of guys complain about how loud reefers are when... I hate parking next to a reefer because it's so loud. So I park over here by myself, and if they park next to me, that's on them if they don't, if they're complaining about it. See what I mean? And the guy had to park... You know, usually you try to park your window so you don't see each other type thing, a little privacy. Can we have a little bit of privacy? Let me back up a little bit. Just a little bit, I'm gonna rip those. That's pretty good right there. He's pouring his urine out, look at that. Brilliant. Just pour it on the ground where you're stepping, that's great. Where everybody else steps too. That's just wonderful. Oh my gosh. Truck drivers are such pigs. You know, I like to have my dog in the truck, but when I see stuff like that, guys are just pouring their urine right out on the right. Open the door and pour the urine directly on the ground where everybody walks, and they don't care because they're driving off, right? But do they know that the previous driver may have poured the urine there too? Do they not understand that? Truck drivers are a pretty foul unit. Pretty foul people, pretty much. Pretty much. I'll show you. Look at that. Right where the step is, he poured the urine. Brilliant. Just disgusting. Okay, let's talk. All right, party people, we are in our... I don't know if it's the third or fourth installment, it doesn't matter. We're going to do another CRAPS video. I want to do a talk about today. We're going to do come and don't come bets, and we're going to do player, should we do player A and player B? Yeah, okay, so we're going to do our numbers 4, 6, 8, 9, and 10, right? I haven't played in so long, and we'll go. These are our point numbers that on the come out roll will be established. We're going to do, we said come and don't come, right? So we're not worried about the pass line right now. We're going to call this come over here on this side. And we're going to split it in half down here like this. Come side and don't come side. Don't. We can do both at once. See, this will, what this will do is, expedite the, I can do both at once because they're basically the same. Come and don't come are the similar to pass line and don't pass line. The difference is you cannot put a bet on don't come or come. You cannot put a bet on these places until the point is established. And we know this by, there's a puck. It says on, O-N. And you flip it over to the other side, it says off. If the puck says off, and the dice are in the middle and the puck says off, we know that the game is just getting ready to start. In other words, it's going to start with a come out roll, or that we know that the 7 out has just occurred. 7 out! And they quickly flip the puck over to off, from on to off. And it's not, and the bets that are existing are not working unless the player specifies they're working. Let's say you had a come bet that traveled. Let's say you had a bet that traveled up to the 5, for example, but the point was 9. The shooter threw a 9. 9, neater, 9, winner, 9, front line winner, 9, da 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 da. So your $5 bet or whatever your bet is on 5 will stay there. On the come out roll, it's risk at the 7. The 7 would lose that. However, a 5 would win. But it's not working. So if an 8 hits, or a 2 or 3 or 11 or 12 hits, it's not affected. If a 5 hits, it wins. If a 7 hits, it loses on a comeback. Now, well, I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's just jump into this right now. And you remember the odds. On a come, it's 3, 4, 5. Times 5. And on a don't come, we're going to go with 6 times odds, because that's the casinos I play over here. I got a few comments about the don't come odds. One suggestion was don't even bother with anything less than 10 times odds. I think it was 10 or 20. I kind of agree with that. However, they got another argument, a great argument. The guy, I wouldn't say argument, would I say debate? I don't know what he said. The guy made a comment. He said, the $35 bet and the odds bet. The guy with the odds is only at risk for the $5 bet, base bet, against the 7, whereas the other guy could lose the entire 35 off the bat. Now, getting ahead of myself again. So we're going to put a $5 bet over here, 5 on the come. The point is established. Whatever number is established, it doesn't matter. We'll say 9 for now. And the puck is on 9. This guy's going to put a $5 don't come bet. The next point that's thrown, 2-3-12 does 2-3-12 loses here. Is that right? And a 2-3 wins, and a 12 is nothing. 12 or 2 pushes. In other words, doesn't. But a 7-11 wins here, and a 7-11 loses here. So those are the rules. What else? So the guy, he's going to throw a point. Whatever number he throws, our chip is going to travel on the come side of that number. And if he, let's say he throws a 4, he's got to hit a 4 before a 7 for this player come bet to win. But if he throws a 4, my don't come player is going to travel behind it. And he needs a 7 before the 4 to win. You see what I mean? So he's got to get a 7 before the 4. 7 before the 4. This guy needs a 4 before the 7 to win. And that is how that works. And now, because we know that 7 comes up the most, it's a pretty attractive bet, don't come bet. You're at risk of the 7. I just said the 7 comes up the most. So when you put a bet down on don't come bet, the don't come field, you are at risk of the 7. Remember, 7-11 loses over here. So you're at risk of the number that comes up the most. And that's my next video, is lay bets, which is I like lay bets. They're a little bit higher house advantage. Now these bets, this is 1.41% house advantage, and this is 1.40% house advantage. Virtually the same, slightly better over here, but not significantly enough to worry about. Not enough to swing you to play that way most of the time, but I would say if you know the 7 comes up a lot, if you're observing and noticing trends in the table that a 7 is coming up a lot, a don't pass or a don't come would be not the worst strategy in the world. And you remember, you remember it's 2-1, 2-1, 3-2, 6-5, 6-5, oops, 3-2, 2-1. And it's just the opposite on the top. It's 1-2, 2-3, 5-6. 5-6, 2-3. This is so sloppy. 1-2. Okay. That means you got to put up the 2 units to win the 1 unit. You got to put up the 3 units to win the 2 units, and you got to put up the 6 units to win the 5 units if you want to lay odds. Remember what we said, lay odds. Over here, if you want to do a come bet and your come bet travels to the number, you would put the 1 unit to win the 2 on the 4 and 10, and you would put the 2 units to win the 3 units on 5 and 9, and you would put the 5 units to win the 6 units on 6 and 8. And like I said, it's just as similar to pass line and don't pass line bets. If you want to refer to those two videos I made, the difference being that you can't put these bets down until the point has been established. The point must be established with the puck. It's black on, off, and white on. And when you see the white on, I'll tell you one great strategy. You walk up to the table, and the puck is on, and you walk up and throw your money on the table. Boom. They give you chips. And let's say the dicer have to be in the middle for this. So you want to make sure you don't throw your money down when the dice are about ready to be thrown. You want to make sure your hands are up when the dice are out. When the dice are not in the middle, when the stick person hooks the dice with his little stick and they start moving, hands up always. It's etiquette. Now, what you can do is make a verbal bet too. You throw a $100 bet on the table and you'll say something like, give me a come bet. A come bet. Remember, 7 comes up the most. And if you see a lot of chips stacked up on the numbers, because 7 hasn't shown in a while and people were pressing their place bets like crazy, that is a great opportunity for a come bet. And I would throw $100 bill on the come. $100 coming. And if you hear the word 7 out, 7 out! That $100, they'll put another $100 right next to it, and you pick up $200. I mean, you're at risk of a 2-3-12. 2-3-12, there's only one way to roll each one of those. 6 ways to roll a 7. What I do is when the shooter's throwing the dice, I'm counting how many times has he thrown the dice so far. And I got to count on my fingers a lot. So I go like this, third time, fourth time, fifth time. And I just kind of keep it in my hands, my fingers are moving. I go eighth time, ninth time, tenth. He's thrown 10 times without a 7. We're getting close to that 7. 7 is ripe for showing up. You can't really say that because it's, you know, it's superstition type stuff. But I don't know. It's just trending. Trends and probabilities and outcomes. You haven't seen the 7 in a while. Chances are it's going to show up. It shows up like death and taxes. And it shows up at the wrong time a lot of times. It's like, oh my God, here it comes. But let's go on to my next video. Let me turn this off and we'll restart it.